Hi, I'm Lynn.
And I'm Leo. Welcome back to Yoga with Lynn and Leo.
And welcome to day 17 of our 18 days of yoga.
So we hope you've been joining us all the way through. We're nearly at the end now, so don't give up.
Keep going and keep repeating the longer routines. There's three longer routines on day 1, 7 and 13.
So this is a tutorial with three poses, and all you're going to need for this is a blanket. I'm sitting on ours at the moment.
Okay, so we're going to start in a supine action. No, we're not actually. We're going to start in a prone action. So we're going to just rest the head onto the blanket. And then we're going to extend the arms forward. So I'm just going to move out of Leo's way. So I'm just going to straighten Leo up. She's just a little bit lopsided. So we're just going to bring her, her shoulders a little bit this way. That's it. All right. So Leo's just releasing the abdomen because we're going to eventually come into Bhujangasana, which is, some of you will know, is a spinal opening, a back bend. So we're going to extend the arms forward and reach the legs back. So we're getting this prone action of extension and length. So quite an important practice before we start to curve the body. Okay, so hopefully you're enjoying this really nice extension of the body. We're going to take the arms back now and release. And then we're going to roll the blanket for Bhujangasana. So those of you who find these poses really challenging, these mini back bends, then this is really a nice way of working. And it lifts the pelvis. So Leo's going to show you here that the blanket just goes at the very top of the thigh, the crease of the thigh, that's it. And then we take the hands beside the chest here, and you can see that actually there is a little bit of a lift in the frontal thigh area, and then press into the hands and coil the body as you come up. That's it. This is a really challenging action. You can see there's a stop point there. So we have to then lift again, lift again, lift again, lift again. So one of the difficulties is getting those arms straight. So we're going to show you a little bit of work on that now. So release back down. So if you're practicing with us, just take a look at the video. Now, when you come into this action, it's really important that you work the legs very strongly, and the frontal hip bones, these frontal hip bones here, get the lift. So the legs extend, and you have to really lift from that hip region. And that's the most important thing, because these glutes and these lower back muscles have to get that breadth and broadness. And then all of this needs to be broad, all of this needs to be broad, and all of this top area needs to be broad. And this curving needs to come and gradually fold into the body. So we will have another go with this. I'll move myself back a little bit. And then pressing into the hands and just come up a little way. Yes. Now pause. Now you've got to press into your hands to lift those hip bones, not off the blanket, but you can see there's more movement going on here. It's really challenging for Leo to be practicing in this way. But you can see it's a very different action. And then you have to breathe and move through the front body. That's the way to do it. And that really will evolve through time. And so we have to keep on lifting from the base. So this is quite challenging, really, for beginners. It's quite a deep action. So as long as you are just gradually going into this and doing what you can, gradually it will get deeper and deeper as time goes on. And then release in. So this time, And once you get this action and you get this curvature of the spine, we're going to bring in a lift. So we're coming for Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. So taking the hands, but exactly the same action. You're going to see that you lift those pelvic rims, those frontal hip bones up. It's going to lengthen the tailbone very strongly. And you normally get this action as you start to lift out of the body. So lifting up, pressing into the hands. Now use that hands as a fulcrum pause. Now lift from those hip bones. You're going to lift those hip bones, yes. And now tuck the toes under and lift up completely. So you're lifting up from that support. So you're coming into this really beautiful Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. And then releasing. So it's quite a nice table, isn't it?
It does, yes.
And then rest onto the forearms as you are. Okay, so we're going to come into Urdhva Mukha Svanasana without the blanket. So we're coming into this pose, and also you can see that actually when you get length in this action, you can be on the front of the foot rather than tucking under the toes. So let's see where we are with this. Now, pressing into their hands very strongly. Remember those hip bones, we're going to lift them up and just lift and coil the body up. You're waking in that whole chest. Pause there. Lift the frontal hip bones, lift the frontal hip bones, roll the shoulders back and down. And then go and see, can you lengthen and push up? Yes. So you can see now Leo's got the feet tucked the other way. And when you're here, you've got to keep on lifting those hip bones, keep on lifting. Yeah, it's a challenging action. And then release in and rest your forehead onto your forearms. So these baby back bends are really wonderful for the spine, but we have to see that we get that access, and we get that from very strong legs and really good connection and grounding with the palms of the hands, the wrists, and eventually the chest will come up. So that's the finish of our tutorial today.
So thank you for joining us today. I always think calling them baby back bends just doesn't do it justice, does it? They're very strong. If you do them properly, they're very, very strong.
They are really strong. They're the ones that are just on the ground level rather than baby.
Yeah, of course. So we hope you enjoyed the tutorial today and that it's helped you a little bit with these back bends, which can present challenges for many of our students. And we're hoping that you will join us tomorrow for day 18. Namaste. I thought, we can't go into all the, you know, what day 18, you know, the Iyengar Yoga day and stuff.
Yeah. Cool. No way. Okay.